Kubla Cube 2016 has a number of features to define existing ground levels. In this video, we are going to look at the tools available to take off elevations. In this project, we have already loaded a site plan, and we've also defined its position. To start defining the existing ground levels, we click Existing and then Define Terrain. In this window, we can define existing ground using elevation features. These can be site outlines, contour lines, break lines, and points. The different types of feature can all be defined manually by drawing on the screen or loaded in from a file. We will start by defining the outline of the site. On this occasion, we will draw the outline on the screen. We will demonstrate importing features from a file by importing contour lines. These have been created in a CAD program. In this form, we simply select the layers containing the elements we want to import, and they will be automatically converted into contour lines. If our terrain has hard edges, we can also draw or import breakline features. Breaklines have a number of very powerful interpolation options to make this quick and easy. Point levels can also be drawn manually or loaded in from a file. Supported formats include Excel, CAD and CSV. Once we are happy with the features that define our existing terrain, we can click on the OK button. Kubla Cube will then use the features that we have defined to generate a triangulated surface. Once this is done, we can inspect the surface using the mouse. Next to the pointer, X, Y and Z positions are displayed. For example, this is a contour line at 1280.5. You can see the Z value is correct. We can then check that this slopes down until we reach 1280, the next contour line. This is a really useful way to check the existing terrain at any location. With this capability to use contour lines, break lines and points to define terrain, and support for features to be defined manually or from an imported file, Kubla Cube can easily be integrated into your company's workflow. After this step is completed, the next job is to define your earthworks levels, and then produce volume estimates. We will cover these topics in the next videos.